I accordingly do hereby acquit A3 Sandra Nakungu Ssebunya.
In a fully packed courtroom, there were jitters before High Court Judge Wilson Masalu Musene acquitted Sarah Nabikolo. Prosecution had earlier accused Nabikolo of being the sole financer and mastermind of the plot to kill her husband. However, Judge Musene said there was no cogent evidence adduced at the trial beyond reasonable doubt to find her guilty.
It is the finding and holding of this court that different prosecution witnesses, right from PW13, PW16, and PW20, gave different stories, but with no direct link to A3 as being involved in the planning or commission of the offense.
Masalu, however, ruled that Nabikolo's sister, Sandra Nakungu, and Jayden Ashraf, a police officer with Muyenga Community Police, formed a common intention to kill Kasiwukira. The judge further ruled that evidence showed that the vehicle used in the murder, a Pajero Mitsubishi UAE 018A, belonged to Sarah Nakungu.
PW20, PW15, and others on record have proved the identification and participation of Sandra Nakungu in the murder of the deceased Kasiwukira beyond reasonable doubt.
Masalu also revealed that the prosecution evidence squarely placed Ashraf at the scene of the crime in Muyenga, near the home of the deceased, where he was knocked dead.
Jayden Ashraf, now in the dock, was not only seen in the killer vehicle, but that he was the one who knocked the deceased dead.
Justice Musene had earlier on rejected Ashraf's submission, which was part of the accomplice evidence that he was promised 200 million shillings, a job transfer and a big house by businessman Godfrey Chirumira if he implicated the widow Sarah Nabikolo and her sister Sandra Nakungu in the murder plot.
This court finds and holds that the bringing in the name of Chirumira from the blue was like a drowning man trying to hold onto a snake for safety.
He sentenced the duo to 20 years each in prison.
I find a sentence of 22 years appropriate, but I shall subtract the 2 years convicts have been on remand.
After the ruling, the Directorate of Public Prosecutions promised to study the ruling before taking any further decision.
We are yet to look at it. As you remember, a life was taken and justice has to be served. So we are going to look at it and then we shall decide whether we appeal or not.
The late Kasiwukira, a businessman, was knocked dead on 17th October 2014 while jogging near his home in Muyenga. Habad Ziwa, NTV.